Nurse Trish, and I'm here today talking to you about how to use a condom. So this is something that I've been asked before, and I figure it would be to your benefit for me to show you physically how to do this, because if you don't, you don't know what you don't know. So unfortunately, I don't have a phallus penis model to demonstrate on. So I do have a banana, so we're going to make do with this and kind of give you an idea. So the condom works best being used or applied or, you know, rolled on an erect penis. A phallus penis or a soft penis, it will not work on because it's hard to roll on something that is floppy. So what I'm going to do is show you how to do this. So this is would be your condom that you would have. You would open this. You don't want to tear it. You don't want to use scissors on it. You just want to take it out. So there is a way to roll this down. So you know how to roll it by the direction of, you know, you kind of roll it in the direction you need it in. So what you want to do is have the tip of the penis, or excuse me, the tip of the condom with a little air space to it. And then you would roll it down on to the actual penis. And so this is how it would look. This is a protected penis. It's all covered, and there's room for air and for sperm to go into. And so this is how you do this. There's different models and different styles of condoms. So some people have not had success with all models of condoms. So if you find a model that's not working for you, just, you know, have fun and find a new model. So there is Magnums, which I used on this banana, which actually, realistically, I'm not even being funny, that this would be too big for this size of penis. There is a lot of room and just a lot of space in this. So sexually, this is at more risk for falling off with the act of sex. So this might be something that would work better with the size of a lifestyle. So there is also female condoms and other condom products. So this is actually a oral condom. So if you are using a, if you are going to perform oral sex on a partner, which is going to be another video I'm going to talk about oral sex, this is flavored so that, you know, a regular condom has a very latexy taste to it. It's not very appealing, but this is, you know, it's flavored. It'll have the flavor on the back here, and it's strawberry. There's latex-free condoms. Some people are allergic to latex. So you have a latex-free condom that you can use so that you don't get irritated in the vagina, or if it's, the partner has a sensitivity, their penis doesn't get irritated. There's also other things for oral sex, which, like I said, we'll talk about in the next video. And this is called a dental dam, and I'll show you really how to do this. And I have an assistant, you'll see. He's a helper. He's really after this banana, actually. So this is called a dental dam, and you would put this over. So if you were a male doing oral sex on a female, you could put this over the area of the vagina. So, and then you would have a protected surface to do the oral sex on. If you were a male having sex with males, you could put this in the rectal area and for stimulation, and it would give them, it would give you protection with them. This is, like I said, a banana flavor. And it does have a flavor to it. I've tasted it. It does taste like banana. There is a female condom, and how you would use this. This is a little bit more of something that you would want to practice with before becoming sexually active with the partner, because there is a ring in this. And this, if this was, pretend my vagina, or vagina, you need to guide this into the vagina, and it pops into something called the cervical rim. And so you can't, this would be something that's inside the body. If you were superwoman or superman, you could see through the body, maybe you could see this, but there's a cervical rim that it, that this needs to get placed in. You'll know, because if they try to be sexually active with you, this would be stuck in the vagina and they would keep on hitting this ring. So you know it's in place when it, you kind of feel like it's a little bit more even. This has to stay outside the vagina, and if you give this a tug, it shouldn't come back out like this. If it's coming back out, this ring is not in the cervical rim that you need it to be in. This does have to be outside the vagina because the penis has to have a direction of where it's going. So you want it to be outside the vagina so the penis can go in and this stays out for the purpose of using the female condom. And then after the sexual encounter is done, you would just be able to guide this back out. There would be sperm in here. You might want to twist this, and then there would be sperm in this. And this is all one-time use stuff. So everything is disposed of after the sexual encounter. Even if it's a failed sexual encounter and it doesn't happen how you expected it to, or things changed, things got disrupted, this is a one-time use. Everything gets thrown away. So that is some of the stuff I have to show you in my Nurse Trish's condom dish. And stay well, stay healthy, and much love and much respect. Take good care.